On Valentine's Day 2019, just prior to 5 p.m., two plainclothes Santa Clara County Sheriff's deputies observed an illegally parked SUV. As the deputies walked toward the vehicle to contact the male and female occupants, it suddenly fled by driving forward over a curb and down a landscape embankment onto an adjacent street. The deputies ran back to their van, broadcast what occurred, and began checking the nearby streets. The deputies observed the SUV moments later, and a pursuit began. The female suspect leaned out the window and fired four shots from a shotgun, striking the deputy's vehicle. The uninjured deputies continued to pursue the SUV. San Jose Police Helicopter Air 3 was on routine patrol with Officer Christopher Cubasta serving as TFO. Cubasta heard the pursuit over the radio and directed his pilot to fly toward it. Arriving overhead, Cubasta calmly advised that he had the vehicle and would call the pursuit. The sergeant monitoring the event advised Air 3 to take over the primary radio responsibility and directed his deputies to back off a bit for safety reasons. Air 3 followed the SUV with Cubasta providing a running narrative for pursuing deputies. After driving the wrong way on the highway and making several turns on local streets, the suspects abandoned their vehicle on foot into a large condominium development. Cubasta broadcast detailed descriptions of both suspects and their direction of travel, noting that the female was possibly carrying a long gun. The suspects fled into the interior courtyard of the complex, where Air 3's view was intermittently blocked during their orbits over the scene. Cubasta, however, was able to see them confront a UPS driver who was on foot making a delivery before he temporarily lost his view. When the area came back into view, all three parties were no longer visible, and a nearby UPS truck was beginning to drive away. Cubasta calmly relayed his observations over the radio while using the aircraft's daylight camera to confirm that the UPS driver and both suspects were in the cab of the delivery van. He advised responding ground units that it was now an apparent hostage carjacking situation. Cubasta's running narrative of the UPS van's location allowed a deputy to successfully deploy a spike strip. As the delivery truck made its way on flat tires through local streets, Cubasta directed plans and requested assets he felt may be needed to take the suspects into custody. He also requested that ground units respond to the original scene to secure the suspect's abandoned SUV, which was later determined to be stolen and contained ammo, duct tape, and zip ties. The UPS van eventually came to a stop 26 minutes after the pursuit began. While providing detailed updates as to the exact locations and actions of the occupants in the van, Cubasta also established inner and outer perimeters, including traffic control points to shut down major roadways and a light rail system. As more resources arrived, he coordinated the efforts between the patrol, tactical, and crisis negotiation resources of both the Sheriff's Office and San Jose Police. The female suspect surrendered without incident shortly after the delivery truck stopped. After being held hostage for several hours, the UPS driver was released by the male suspect while Air 3 had departed the scene to refuel. Upon returning, Air 3 continued to provide updates and coordinate with tactical units on the ground. Eventually, the suspect restarted the van and drove it a short distance, resulting in tactical vehicles moving in to block its path and prevent further movement. Cubasta was able to warn the tactical team the suspect was pointing the shotgun at them as they approached, and that the suspect was about to flee out the passenger door. The suspect fled on foot carrying the shotgun. Cubasta provided updates of the suspect's location while keeping him in the spotlight so perimeter officers could evaluate the threat. A San Jose Police Department perimeter officer, positioned between a group of news crews and the suspect, fired a single round from his patrol rifle, killing the suspect. The presence of Air 3 overhead and TFO Cubasta's actions were a decisive factor in the successful resolution of this incident. He demonstrated outstanding skill and leadership by providing clear, calm, and detailed updates that allowed ground officers to remain safe maintain situational awareness, and reposition as needed. He stayed mentally ahead of the event, anticipating contingencies, and provided critical tactical information that helped the situation resolve to a peaceful conclusion for the hostage and one of the suspects. For his exemplary performance providing situational awareness to responding officers while operating tactical flight equipment, coordinating ground assets, and maintaining visual contact of a dynamic incident, the Airborne Public Safety Foundation presents its 2019 Tactical Flight Officer Award to Officer Christopher Kubasta.